guys, and welcome to my kitchen, Midnight Munchies and More. I am your chef, Charisse, and this week, a sucked balls. So you know what you do when life sucks balls? You pour some liquor over it and make some vegan bourbon balls. So that's what we're gonna motherfucking do today. Now, since we're not baking off the liquor, you should probably use like a top shelf bourbon, but this broke bitch is going bottom shelf and it's still gonna be delicious. So that leads me into my next point. I wanna give a super huge shout out to Holly and Amanda. Thank you guys so much for helping to support this channel. You guys can donate too if you get value out of my recipes. Go to PayPal and donate to Midnight Munchies and More at yahoo.com. That will be linked below. So let's get to bourbon making, girl. Apparently, there are two different ways to make bourbon balls. And as I was reading a bunch of recipes on the internet, I found out that there is the proper old school way to make them. So that's what I'm gonna do here. So I read this one thing on Pinterest that was like, if you come across a bourbon ball recipe that calls for vanilla wafers and corn syrup, run. So we're not doing that today. So what I have is 1 cup of chopped pecans that I added 1/3 of a cup of bourbon to. Now, I did this 2 days ago. So general rule, like, you could just do this overnight, soak your nuts. But if you want more bourbon in there, more flavor, girl, you just let them keep going. Like, 3 to 5 days is optimal, but like, I didn't want to wait any longer. So now I'm going to actually just strain these out because I put a little extra bourbon in them. Like, if you start running out halfway through the process, like it's the next day and you want to let them soak longer, but you're out of bourbon, just add some more bourbon. When you're done straining, girl, you know I ain't gonna waste that good bourbon. Oh my God, look at that with all the nuttiness. This is gonna be the best shot ever. In this bowl, we have 1/2 cup of a vegan quote butter replacement, and we're just gonna use our hand mixer and we're gonna whip it up until it's a little bit more creamy and softer. I did leave this at room temperature for just about 1/2 hour to get it a little bit softer, so it's easier. I have 3 1/2 cups of vegan powdered sugar or confectioner sugar, or if you're like my grandma and like those old school recipes that said like 10 times sugar, that's what it means. So we're gonna add this a little bit at a time and just beat it up. As you can see, our mixture is a lot like a coarse sand now. So then we're gonna add our boozy soaked nuts all up in here to make our balls beat. As you can see, as we mixed our soaked nuts in there, even though we had drained them out, it kind of pulls all of that butter and powdered sugar together to make this nice goopy mess. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cover this completely and I'm gonna put this in the refrigerator to chill out, let that butter stiffen up a little bit more so that we can roll out our balls. So actually, while we wait in, girl, for this to get all hard, oh, beat. Okay. While we're waiting on that, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and that little bell notification so that you don't miss any more of my recipes as soon as I upload, baby. This has been in the fridge for about 1 hour, so we have our hardened nutty mixture, and I'm just gonna take a scooper and put it on some parchment paper that I have on a cookie sheet just to help me put it in the fridge and out of the fridge. You know what I'm saying. So we're gonna scoop all of these first. Then we're gonna come in here with our balls and we're gonna lightly roll them. Now, they will be sticky. We got sticky balls, you guys. We got sticky balls full of nuts, okay? And we're just gonna roll them around a little bit. And once we have them all rolled, we're gonna go ahead and pop these into the freezer while we prepare our chocolate to dip them in. We're gonna take 1/2 of our vegan chocolate and either put it in the microwave in 30-second intervals, stirring until you get it melted, or put it on a double broiler, like you do, you boo. But we're only gonna do 1/2 of it. I use the Enjoy Life brand of the chunks. I love them. They're super awesome, vegan and gluten-free. I'm using dark chocolate today, but like, you do, you boo. Once we have our chocolate melted, we're going to add the 2/2 and we're gonna mix this in until these are all melted as well. And this is kind of like a super easy bullshit way to temper your chocolate without getting too fancy and technical. Our chocolate is finally nice and smooth. Just be patient. I promise they will melt. So now I'm gonna take a fork and I'm gonna get one of my volleyballs. It's nice and cold beach, and we're gonna dip them in. And like, sometimes you gotta make the chocolate happen, especially if you don't have a whole bunch like I don't right now, and just get that baby all covered up. Oh no, beach, don't fall. And then just like, you know, let them hang out for a couple of seconds. Get the extra chocolate off. Oh, chocolate balls. And then we just gonna lay that guy right on down there. And let him hang out. And go on to the next one. Put our ball on there. And get them in our chocolate. And then if you want to, before they harden, you can drop a couple extra pieces of chopped pecans, which, whoops, that one already started to harden. So, like, yeah, you know, just fucking do what you gotta do. I think I got into the bourbon a little too early, girl. You guys, look, I even already bit into one of them for a picture. Like, look at that. Oh, my God. Okay. So, it's like, it's, like, so creamy. Look at that. Oh, creamy, creamy, cream, beach. Okay. So, you got, hold on. Girl. You got that little snap of that bullshit tempered chocolate. The crunch of the pecans. The creaminess. It's so, so sweet that you don't need very many, which is totally fine because you don't want to get wasted by accident. Or do you? That's why these are perfect for the holiday. If you don't have a shirt, if you didn't see my Swedish tea ball recipe with my Christmas shirt with the stocking, you put a flask in, make some bourbon balls, girl. Just keep them away from the kids and just you do you all Christmas season. And I also wanted to mention my vegan online bakery. The last day to order for you to get my vegan and some gluten-free baked goods to you in time for Christmas. Make sure you order by the 16th. That is Etsy. You can just search And More Store on Etsy, or that will be linked below as well. And I'll just catch you guys next time.
Oh, good night kisses, Wally wishes and reminisces. His eyes kissing, Wally wish for the full moon above. Oh, I will read up, passionate love, listening closely for position in my intuition for her nutrition and ambition, get up. Like when you rise in the morning, rub your eyes in the morning through the skies in the morning, get up. Like when you rise in the morning, rub your eyes in the morning through the skies in the morning, get up.